Here we are, starter day 5 proper. Assuming you just came from the last video, you heard the zombie dogs just pass by. I apologize for not talking as much. I'm trying to finish this as quickly as I can. I'd like to actually see how fast I'm getting this full concrete with iron bars up. Done. And I'm barely going to have enough mix for right now. On the flip side, obviously I have not been producing mix as much as possible, and the forges have been shut off just due to a lack of stone anyway. I'm not sure. Maybe cobblestone is better than wood just to build with initially, for the sole fact that that way you can upgrade it flat out with just the 20 instead of the 10. Without having to tear stuff down, and with it, more importantly, without having to spend the 20 iron as well. Because I will say right now, I'm half wishing I just made like a separate facility. There's like a tiny, I have room for like a storage crate or three, and a forge or two. And then I went and built this base after that base was built. That way I can just throw down the rebar frames and build, instead of having to be demolishing the previously existing structure. I think that probably would have gone better. Of course, that does mean you're still going to probably have to go out and make it like a giant solid block of wood frames that you just keep filling just to level up construction tools. Because if you do the other thing I was talking about, the... like just a point of interest that you temporarily take over or something else. The other thing, and I guess you could still try to mine underneath it, but it feels like it'd be kind of wasted effort unless you're trying to make a tunnel between the two long term. Because ideally, once this base would be complete, by now or even before now, because you weren't going to have to be spending the time to... because you wouldn't be having to spend the time to tear this stuff down, and you wouldn't have had to erect such a large structure in the first place. I don't know. Sort of the final main touch. These. What are these, do you ask? They do several things. One, they're an overhang, which means spider zombies are not able to climb your wall. They will start at the bottom, they'll climb up, they will hit this, they will bounce back down. You are safe from spider zombies breaching your walls if you do this kind of thing. Two, it allows you to shoot down at the zombies. You can stand on the grate and fire down, or you can even stand up here and fire down, right? Arrows and bolts and bullets will all go through this type of bars. The kind of funny thing is that these bars are actually incredibly sturdy for the cost. 2,500 HP for like 4 iron and 1 clay or something. You could almost build a base out of these, frankly. So there you have it. So about 942. Now, ideally, we'd obviously need to replace... I guess, mainly with one spike there and, like, one spike there, and I'd maybe put out a third or fourth row. But other than that, we are ready for the first two hordes. Especially the first horde, as is. We have concrete walls, most of them are done drying. The only ones not done drying are way off... okay, most of the ones not done drying, except for those two jerks down there, way off the floor. So... it doesn't even really matter. And let's get some rebar ramp frames here. We need four. This is one of the other reasons for this specific design, because it allows you to do this. You have a flat surface, you have a ramp up, you have a flat surface, and then you have the wall. That gives you the ability to put every single one of these boxes like this with a open gap on either side to be standing. I mean, theoretically, you could eliminate like this spot right here and have these pressed against the ramp. Of course, it means you have to go all the way around to, like, access anything, and I'm not sure that's really worth it, but it is possible, I suppose. Voila. I'm not really going out to do anything today. I figured I could raise my toolsmithing a bit with those. There's probably still like 15 seconds left, but yeah, I'll wait till this one finishes. Since I don't really want to be going out until I hear the next dog attack, this will serve. Seconds. Now here's the catch. Now you have to spend 30 seconds scrapping it, or you can melt them into the forge and they melt quickly. Good, right? Well, not really, because now it's going to take another several minutes or something before it'll be ready to melt anything again. That iron's just going to be sitting there doing nothing for several minutes. So it's like, I just took 200 iron from the forge. I'm not going to melt anything else for a while, okay? I need to, like, process all that. See how it's still 248 and 250? You'll see that number stay the same for a while. I missed it. Arg. Arg, 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 arg. I'm arg. Shouldn't have gotten greedy there. That is exactly what I was worried about. Precisely what I was worried about. Like, why are you wasting the time of your forge? Well, it's not, doesn't really have that much else to do right now that I'm actually that concerned with, so see how the second anvils have not melted down and the other's still at 248 and 250. On the flip side, when you don't have the ability to really gather plant fibers as safely as you'd like due to dog day and wanting to show that you can, in fact, get by without going out at all for dog day, if you're nervous, then, you know, that's what it is. Don't screw me up by I'll glad we didn't get up here. Oh good, two more anvils down. They finally melted. Decide what I could even have going on in my other crafting queues that I am willing to put in the other crafting queues. Maybe I'll go ahead and stop this at like 50 and start the iron arrows working. I normally would say, well, turn the wood into something, but I only have 1.2 right there. Since I did a game on the default settings, default days, I'm used to either playing with some friends who like very much longer days, or I'm used to playing much shorter days. So I'm trying to figure out how I'm relatively doing. I mean, obviously I'm doing perfectly fine relative to this specific game, but compared to other games, I don't know. Doubt anyone's really too upset about full concrete structure by just past the start of day 5 that's able to easily take on the first 2 weeks' hordes as is, so there's certainly worse fates. Two. I don't really have that much else to do. Basic toolsmithing again, right? So it's like, why not? Another dog attack should be appearing anytime soon. Anytime soon doesn't really make a ton of sense. Out that this isn't really that urgent of a thing to be raising, because I'm already one-shotting dirt with the shovel, the pickaxe is already two-shotting the stone, so it's not like he exactly benefits from... If the pickaxe is doing two shots, then it's not going to be able to one-shot until, like, being purple quality with 5 out of 5 minor 69 or like nearly 100 mining tools. Don't need those there anymore, do I? So I have enough for about 40 more wood frames, right? Which is not even two circuits around the edge, like one and a half. I suppose I can try to do it on at least like the upper layer. To 46 skill without even realizing I didn't have the next rank. Interesting. anvils and throw new ones on to re-melt. Will they instantly remelt, or are we still on the long delay of the previous anvil? Looking like we're still on the delay of the previous anvil. So that works out just fine for me. Bring some torches down here. I think I do have like the 20 in my pack, right? What did I put the 19 in the supply crate and kept the other 50 on myself? I guess we'll see. To be a bit more eager in terms of pursuing that and not risking the base collapsing, as in it would not collapse. Yeah, but unless you're very sure about how it works, the structural integrity rules, you're better off being safe than sorry. That's one of the reasons I'm trying to play that way right now. I'm just literally working my way down within this 6x4 area. Some nitrate powder. And there's a whole bunch of stuff that way we could be getting. And there's bunches of stuff this way too. But the sort of a motto to sort of try to keep in mind, it will still be there. It ain't going anywhere. You don't have to try to excavate it right this second and risk dying and or having your base collapse. Is this... I think that's just regular stone, though. That's not, though. Thank you. some people don't like mining. Personally, I generally don't mind it. There's a certain rhythm to it, at least. A sense of discovery when you find the ore veins and trying to figure out how do I extract all that without collapsing gravel on myself and killing myself, or conversely, collapsing the base on me and not just killing myself, but worse, killing the base. I don't know if this is... It doesn't really seem like the continuation of one vein, because there's nothing here in between them as far as I seem to be seeing. This is two separate veins that we happen to find. So, you know... Nice. Swing in effect down here while tunneling down. Like a 25 per 500. Nightfall in 10 seconds. The other good news is those trees should be at like the 500 each stage, and we planted like, what, 20 to 30 of them, so that's another 5 to 7.5k easy lumber right there. This is an extremely vertical vein. Not sure what a better word to describe it is. Into our prime region. And it is 100% perfectly acceptable to go chasing after those vans, to be clear. But you just want to be careful about the way that you do it whenever it's directly underneath one of your base's main walls. You ideally want to be, like, basically what we did above it, right? If you take out a section, reinforce it, then, it, like, at some point, we can make almost like a door, right, through the reinforcement and leave what basically one of the wall segments unsupported compared to the others. But since this base is not, like, hinging on everything supporting everything all at once to not collapse, it's over-engineered, it has some quite a bit of leeway, it can easily withstand a few unsupported columns like that. Can't support like half of them or something not being supported though, having gaps beneath them. Down as we came. Wow. Look how time flies when you're mining all day. You manage to excavate an entire pit the size of what you, to the depth that you managed to tunnel down, straight down to before. That's gravel there, that's not gravel there. If you try to put a torch in the gravel, here's what happens. Whoops! Fell down, broke. Gravel can't support it. That's why it matters. Ratcheting up that mining tool skill, which is one of the whole reasons for that, right, is experience. Gets us more levels, gets us better loot, gets us more points to buy the stuff we want. Which is mainly going to be scavenging and quality Joe, in terms of skill-focused things. And there'll be some other perks we want, like leatherworking, the fixer, run forced run at max, sexual tyrannosaurus, at least another point or two, and so on. Right now I'm kind of trying to figure out if there's like going to be any realistic point at which this pit gets shot and stuff. Down to 30 seconds per anvil now. How about that? Well, I suppose the good news is we have enough stone that we can actually begin firing up the other forges. try putting 250 in each and seeing what happens. What, 48 swings to clear another level right now. And then we're going to, of course, be going back and clearing one out further in each direction and reinforcing it. So we'll have to go back, but right now we just don't have... spikes and die, please. I don't know if she just wandered away or something else. Like, it's kind of weird. The pickaxe is definitely starting to do less damage, but, you know... Just to drop another full 60 points until it's not gonna two-shot. Obviously what I have there is kind of less than safe. You have to be exceedingly careful about going down those stairs, or else you can easily break a leg. Dead yet, Screamer. Is she like stuck behind one of those giant weight locks? I almost think that's gotta be what it is. She just can't get to the base because she's just spazzing out or something. I don't think I'm going to really be trying to melt any more anvils here. Note that you can also extend platforms out just made of wood to make sure they don't fall. That would be safer, really, than what I'm doing right here. For example, something that's like this, right? And you're like, hey. And then put put that across. It's like, hey, now you can't fall quite as far. Then you'd presumably repeat that down here. No, maybe around sort of the level is 1, 2, 3, 4. Something like this would probably be okay, a good way to. At 445s there, nice. Handle's good. Screamer who won't die bad. Actually down now to clay not being in sufficient quantities. How about that? So tomorrow I'll probably, among other things, I'll get a whole bunch of clay and just load the main forge full of it and just pump it full of clay for a while, so we never have to worry about it again, sort of. Bedrock is usually like negative 57 in theory. Day 6 video incoming.